We need to just look into some very basic things. In fact, I would like to leave you with just 3 points, which if you carry home with you and if you practice, I think you can make the life of your child wonderful. The first one is communication. Learn how to communicate with your child. And you know how communication is spelled? I don't know if there's an English teacher here. According to my English teacher, communication is spelled L-I-S-T-E-N. Listen to your child. Otherwise, there's a proverb which says, we spend the first 2 years of a child's life teaching him how to talk and spend the next 16 years of his life telling him to shut up. We want to do all the talking. Please don't do that. Learn to listen to your child. Even if your child is a tiny tot, he may not have something earth-shaking to tell you, but learn to listen to his emotions. That's what a child needs. Let the whole world go in one direction. Let the child come back with that warm, reassuring feeling that my amma and my appa listen to me. They may not agree with me, but they listen to me. Point number one. Point number two, a lot of people ask me, since we are basically counselors and we do a lot of counseling and all that, people ask about discipline matters. I tell them one very basic and important thing: consistency in discipline. Make any rule that you want, as long as you can justify it and you stick to that rule. Don't keep changing rules. That is what makes a child very upset. And the worst thing that you can do is what we call as, you know, treating parenting as a popularity contest. Doing your parenting to impress others. My mother-in-law should not get an impression that I am a bad mother, so when my mother-in-law is here, I will behave differently with my child. When I go to the mall, people are watching when my child is throwing a tantrum, so let me buy and give it off to him. You're doing the wrong thing. Be consistent in whatever you feel. Believe in it. When you believe in whatever discipline you are doing, the child agrees with you. If you tell lies, if you bluff, if the child says, I want to buy this toy, and you say, we don't have the money for it, it is costing 200 rupees, we don't have the money. And then you go and buy something which is 2000 rupees worth, you think the child doesn't know? That is what I said, when you impose, when you say, I don't want to buy it, you say, I have the money. I have 10 times the money, but I don't think this is worth buying. That's my opinion. I am your father, I am your mother. I want to tell you this. Then let the child throw any number of tantrums. The third and perhaps the most important of the 3 points that I wanted to share with you is to be a good role model. That's what I said. Today's children have no role models. Let the parents be a role model. Let the parents tell the truth to the child. 10 times we tell the child that telling lies is a sin. And halfway through our telling the child, we pick up the mobile phone and we start talking. Yes, sir. Yes, definitely. I will see that your material is dispatched. I'm in the factory right now. I will ensure that the material is dispatched. Then only I'll go home, sir. Yeah. Child looks at appa. He's telling a lie. Then he looks at amma. Amma used to give so many lectures about telling lies. No, now she'll get very angry with appa. She says, "Arey, good you told him off. Otherwise, if you had said you are at home, he would have landed up here." This is what it is. Very simple. But be very careful, because there's a proverb that says children are very poor at listening to their parents, but they are very good at mimicking them. They pick up cues like this. They are always observing you. If you don't believe me, today evening go home, give a half an hour lecture to your child and he doesn't listen to a single word. After that you say, okay, you go and play. And both mother and father go to one corner and start talking. Immediately his antenna goes up. He starts coming closer and closer. What is going on over here? So you have, on the one side, a very important role. On the other side, you also have to understand that a child is like a sapling. The seed has, you know, sprouted. The child is now growing up. You cannot dictate whether this plant should give you mangoes or apples. It will give what it wants. You cannot dictate that your child wants to be an engineer. If he wants to be a fashion model, he'll turn out to be a very happy fashion model. It is you who will be sitting and breaking your head against the thing. The same way as we nurture a plant and allow the plant to grow up and be what it is, whether the plant is giving, and every plant is unique, the same way every child is unique. One child will give shade, one child will give fruits, one child will give flowers, one child will grow very fast, one child will grow very slow. Allow the child to grow at his or her own pace. Respect the individuality of the child.